A U.S. Navy warship, USS Portland, will have a laser 5 times stronger than the one the service has tested in the past. The amphibious transport dock ship is being outfitted with a 150-kilowatt laser system. This is a significant upgrade from 30-kilowatt laser weapon system, or LAWS, that the U.S. Navy tested on the amphibious transport dock ship, USS Ponce, about 5 years ago. Thomas Rivers, program manager for the Amphibious Warfare Program Office, said at the Modern Day Marine 2019 Expo that big things are expected from the Portland's new laser. He added, "They're just putting it on the ship now, and this may be the beginning of seeing a lot more lasers coming into different ships." It's to be noted that in 2018, USS Portland was selected to host a laser weapon technology demonstration by the Office of Naval Research, ONR. In this video, Defense Updates reports on the deployment of 150-kilowatt laser system in USS Portland. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft or ship, and 3 days of premium account. The defensive weapons package of U.S. Navy warship consists of the following. 1. Evolved Sea Sparrow Missiles, ESSM, is the primary air defense system. It has a range of 10 nautical miles, or 19 kilometers, and a speed of Mach 3.5. Arleigh Burke class has 96-cell Mark 1 vertical launch system, whereas Ticonderoga class 122 of these. Each can be quad-packed with ESSM. 2. RIM 116 Rolling Airframe Missiles is a small, lightweight, infrared homing surface-to-air missile meant for point defense. It has a speed in excess of Mach 2 and has a range of 9 kilometers or 5.6 miles. 3. Phalanx Close-In Weapon System is deployed for last-ditch defense against airborne threats. It uses an automated 20mm Gatling gun, which is capable of firing up to 50 rounds per second. 4. Several kinds of guns like M2 Browning machine gun and Bushmaster 2 30mm. These weapons are not enough to defend against hypersonic weapons or drone swarms. Also, they could potentially be saturated by a barrage of supersonic anti-ship missiles. America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report had stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. Viewers can go through the report from the link given in the description section below. This technically means that U.S. warships and supercarriers are vulnerable to strikes. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats. There's also concern that drone swarm technology is a growing threat. Some reports have indicated that China is actively working on drone swarm technology as a method of attacking aircraft carriers and surface ships. Recently, Iran deployed drones against USS Boxer. High-speed boats laden with explosives and missile-firing fast attack craft can also be a menace for large warships like cruisers and destroyers, especially in shallow water where their movement is constrained. And this is where laser weapons come in. USS Portland, LPD 27, is a San Antonio-class warship in the United States Navy. San Antonio-class is a class of amphibious transport docks, also called a landing platform dock, LPD. USS Portland's keel was laid down on the 2nd of August 2013 at the Ingalls Shipbuilding Yard in Pascagoula, Mississippi. Portland was commissioned on the 14th of December 2017. The San Antonio class was designed to provide the U.S. Navy and U.S. Marine Corps with a modern sea-based platform that's networked, survivable, and built to operate with 21st century transformational platforms, such as the MV-22 Osprey. USS Portland is 684 feet long and 105 feet wide. It's designed to be LO, low observable, and has features that reduce radar cross-section. It's capable of transporting U.S. Marines, amphibious vehicles, conventional landing craft, and rotary aircraft. This means it has the capability to support amphibious assault, special operations, or expeditionary warfare missions. USS Portland also provides a high-quality command and control capability and improved interoperability between U.S. forces and partners in the region. It's packed with different kinds of sensors. The ship's enclosed main mast consists of two large eight-sided structures. The mast houses the radar and communications components, like antennae, and has a hybrid frequency selective surface. The ship's radars package consists of an ITT-AN-SPS-48E 3D air search radar operating at C and D band. Lockheed Martin's AN-APQ-9B surface surveillance and tracking radar operating at I band. Raytheon's AN-SPS-64V9 navigation radar operating at I band. And two Northrop Grumman Norden systems AN-SPS-73 surface radars operating at I band. The weapon is a next-generation upgrade from the U.S. military's laser weapon system, LAWS. The laser will be bolted to the deck. Because the installation will be only a trial, it will not be integrated into the ship's warfare system. Since it's much more powerful, it's expected to take out targets much further away. Also, it will be able to disable them in a much shorter time. Viewers may note that the 30-kilowatt LAWS was able to demonstrate significant capabilities when it was tested in 2014. The U.S. Navy had released video of the LAWS on deployment disabling a Scan Eagle UAV, detonating a rocket-propelled grenade, and burning out the engine of a rigid hull inflatable boat. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. They're also much cheaper and could cost as little as a dollar per shot. Laser technology is still relatively new, and scientists and engineers are working round the clock to master it. There are many challenges when it comes to using the laser for combat usages. American military's tryst with laser weapons is not new. In 2010, the Air Force mounted and fired off a megawatt-class chemical laser from a modified Boeing 747. Things have changed since then, and instead of unstable chemical laser used for that experiment, solid-state lasers are now being used. The SHIELD program is developing a directed energy laser system that will act as a demonstrator for a self-defense system that could eventually enable aircraft to protect themselves from surface-to-air, SAM, and air-to-air, AAM, missiles. On April 23, 2019, the U.S. Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, Self-Protect High Energy Laser Demonstrator, SHIELD, Advanced Technology Demonstration, ATD, program successfully achieved a major goal. A laser developed as part of the program had shot down several air-launched missiles in flight. The system could be deployed as an add-on pod in the future. It's evident that laser will have a significant part to play in future combat, and they're becoming reality much faster than we could imagine a decade earlier.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.